my ghost. This is my message to the government. The revolution will be televised. We get into infiltrators, culture vultures. I'm tired of holding back, and I'ma give them the full clip, and we get into it on this episode of Demons Row TV. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby. Welcome to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture, where we cover everything Motorcycle Club involved. I'm Chopper Sosa, I'm your host for the evening, and today we're gonna get into it, my message to the government. But before we do that, I want you to hit me with that pound ghosting, and that lets me know you're alive and well, sitting on tools, doing what you do. Shout out to all my new subscribers. Welcome to the row. Hit the bell so you get the notification. Any force, have you ever been in a position where any force possible was in the way of you trying to accomplish something? I swear, any car that could pass by, any rain that could come down, any condition. The last time I tried to shoot, there was rain actually falling in the camera where I couldn't shoot. And it's because I wanted to just let everything out. And the first thing I want to talk about real quick on a side note is Demons Row. People ask me where I got the name from, and I had a Christian person that I really went at it with in the comments, and he was talking about that I'm worshiping the devil, and then I'm pushing the devil's agenda and everything. Listen, man, Demons Row came from my club when we were all riding in rows. You know, we ride in two rows and high and tight. You know how that shit goes if you're in a real MC. And when we were riding, I seen the skulls on the backs, and I thought, you know, the demons in rows. So that's where it came from. There's no devil worshiping or any of the sort. And this misconception that you gotta believe in the devil just because you're in an MC, you know, it's just bullshit, and it's just adds to everything that comes. Even sees the fucking car, bitch ass motherfucker, while I'm trying to record, like, how dare he come in my motherfucking area. Now my message to the government is this: this is a shot at anybody who ever has befriended any MC and then turned around and took him away from his family. The infiltrators, you're literally getting to know brothers' wives, children, and then you're gonna take them away from their family. But somehow you think that you're doing good? Like, let's keep it all the way real with all these infiltrations. One person in a state could be selling drugs. One brother could be selling drugs. In another state, some shit could happen. There's a murder, whatever. They pin this one with that one, and then now it's the whole club. How many clubs have they gone after right now? They're going after everybody. Y'all are getting these clubs. Y'all commit crimes. You'll go write books, go on YouTube, go on all these sources and reveal the stuff that was going on around you, but you were doing it with them. And then it's like, where is the moral high ground of that? You're committing crimes yourself. And then you're putting brothers away for a long time. You're putting whole organizations out for a long time. And this shit all goes back to the Mongols. We need to stick together. It's time for us to take a stand against this government. They are sick to their stomach when they see MCs. You wanna know why? There's a lot of military in MCs. Yes, I'ma say it, and nobody's gonna silence me. I'ma tell the truth. And this is what happens. They try to get rid of you when you tell the truth. Well, guess what? Sosa's gonna tell the truth, and whatever comes, comes. It's the truth. We need to unite. All this shooting each other over territory and all that. Listen, I'm the first one to give out protocol and tell you, yo, listen, you gotta move like this or move like that when you're in this state or that state. And honestly, that's not the way I want it to be. And I'm not co-signing it. I'm never saying that it's cool for this type of shit to happen and for people to get caught up for wearing the wrong state or the wrong colors and getting their cuts taken by one percenters. I'm not co-signing any of it. I'm just exposing the realities and trying to get people prepared so they don't get caught up in bad situations. But it is time for us to unite as one. And I've noticed that the more I study everything in life, whenever people unite, they try to break you up. Democrat, Republican, Blood, Crip, whatever forum you're in, they find a way to separate you while they stay together. Do you think that if we put some negative propaganda out there about the police force, do you think they're gonna go against each other? No, they're gonna stick together. So why are we allowing ourselves constantly in every situation, period, doesn't matter what state you're in. And listen, in the other countries, they're banning clubs. Look at what they're doing to the Mongols. They already targeted them. Now they're going after 81. They're going after Pagans. They're going after everybody. Little by little, they're going to do the same shit that they're doing in these other countries, and they're going to ban us in this country. We need to stand together as men, as women and SCs, old ladies, whoever it is. We need to stand together and unite. My ghost, I'm going to tell you like this, man. Once this drops, you're going to have trolls hop in the comments. And I'm gonna tell you right now, if you troll what I'm saying right now, this truth, this real, you a cop. I don't care what nobody says. Any trolls in the comment of what I'm kicking right now, you are a cop, my friend. And listen, my ghost, land base them if they jump in the comments with that bullshit. And listen, man, let's hold all each other to a higher standard. If you're on YouTube and you're doing videos, listen, don't drop brothers' names and then read articles saying motorcycle gang and all that, and then putting their face with their case and all that. Let's hold ourselves to a higher standard, and let's do the right thing when we're posting up anything that has to do with a case that a brother's life is on the line. Like, I understand you're doing news, but we gotta find a better way to do this where we're not putting brothers' faces and cases out there. And whoever don't like what I'm saying, listen, man, I'm speaking the truth. And the truth is never the popular thing to say, because I don't see nobody else talking about this. I don't see none of the other MCs talking about this. And I don't watch everybody else's channels. And shout to Raven Dixie, Urban Legends. We're gonna be doing some work real soon, some special stuff. But we need to keep it all the way real out here and work together and keep this infiltrating perspective of MCs out, this gangland bullshit. It's all, like I said before, it's all rats. It's all people that got kicked out of clubs that are disgruntled. Like, y'all disgruntled dudes, man. If you got kicked out of club, man, listen, if you can't hack it being an MC, stop jumping in the comments and trolling. Be a fucking man. Find something else to do. Let me know in the comments how you feel about what I'm saying. Do you agree that it's time that we all stick together? Because this shit corny already. Like, how long is this gonna go on where we're just constantly separated by religion, by anything, colors? It's the most basic shit that they separate us with. You know what I'm saying? So I just had to keep it real. That's my message to the government. Cop the Demons Row merch. It's getting cold. Get your Scullies. We got the hoodies, all that. It's always underneath every video. The revolution will be televised. And thank you for tuning in to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture. Like, subscribe, and comment. And oh yeah, we ghostin', baby.